I'm incredibly grateful that we can enjoy this concert in person again and experience some of the best of Bermudian creativity firsthand. Tonight's performances will feature artists who have received sponsorship from either the Department of Culture or the Bermuda Arts Council during the past year, and gives us the opportunity and pleasure to experience the talented Bermudians in whom this government is proud to invest. These outstanding artists and creatives will help us pay homage to 8 persons who have left a lasting impression on the history and culture of our island. Now I'm going off script because at this point in time I'd be tempted to quiz my son and daughter who are in the audience, because last weekend at National Heroes Day they were naming all of the national heroes. But I will name them nonetheless. Dr. Lewis Browne-Evans, Dr. Paolo Camarcafago, Dr. Edgar Fitzgerald Gordon, Sir Henry Tucker, Mary Prince, Gladys Misick Morrell, Sir Edwin Richards, and Sir John Swan. These women and men helped shape our society and led our country through historical changes and progress. Thanks to their courage, determination, and perseverance, saw the abolishment of slavery, the end of segregation, labor laws and workers' rights become a reality, universal adult suffrage, women's suffrage, the writing of Bermuda's constitution, and the development of Bermuda's modern economy. These heroes embody the resilient Bermudian spirit, and we will and should never forget their contributions to our country. I thank the Minister of Youth, Culture, and Sport, the Honorable Dr. Ernest Peets. I thank Dr. Dismont Robinson and the Department of Culture for their hard work and dedication in organizing this annual event. And I also want to give a thank you in advance to all of tonight's performers. I sincerely hope that everyone this evening enjoys this celebration of Bermudian excellence, heroism, and creativity. Thank you for attending the Premier's concert, and enjoy.
The artist that will be performing is J3. J3 is a recording artist, accredited mixing engineer, and radio frequency technician. She has performed both in Bermuda and overseas, with her discography reaching listeners all over the world. Her musical career kickstarted by winning the 2018 Quest for the Best Song competition. And she has also been a recipient of Bermuda Arts Council grant to attend courses to become an AVID certified user, the industry-leading audio production software. J3 has recently released her debut album, Go Getter, and single, Ride, with productions from producers in Bermuda, the US, and the Caribbean, as well as collaborating with a Grammy Award-winning artist and producer. She prides herself on being a go-getter and pushing boundaries to create a sound authentic to who she is. Then we also have Melanie Eddy. She is a renowned sculptural jeweler. Melanie Eddy uses geometry as a tool to explore the relationship between form and the body. As a director of the Association for Contemporary Jewelry, she is also an educator, researcher, and curator. Her studio and workshop is based in London, England. I want you to put your hands together as we pay tribute to Dame Lois Browne-Evans.
The Honorable Dame Lois M. Browne-Evans. Dame Lois Browne-Evans is one of Bermuda's most revered, respected, and influential personalities. Dame Browne-Evans stood at the forefront of law and politics in Bermuda for more than 4 decades. Her accomplishments are legendary, yet they do not overshadow one of her most enduring characteristics, that of her selflessness. She is held in high esteem as the shepherd of an enduring political movement, having achieved many firsts and having broken the glass ceiling in many areas. She became the first female lawyer in Bermuda in 1953. The political arena saw Dame Lois's arrival on the scene in 1963 when she was elected as a Progressive Labour Party Member of Parliament, representing Devonshire North. Dame Lois holds the distinction of being the longest-serving PLP Member of Parliament. In 1968, she became the leader of the Progressive Labour Party, but stepped down from that position in 1972. She resumed the mantle in 1976 and continued to serve as leader of the PLP until 1985. Amongst her other distinguished accomplishments include being the first female opposition leader in the British Commonwealth, the first female and first politically appointed Attorney General, and the first Bermudian to serve as Jamaica's honorary consul in Bermuda. Dame Lois was co-author of Bermuda's Modern Constitution. Dame Lois's accomplishments were not restricted to the political or legal arenas. She became the first female member of the Devonshire Recreation Club. In 1999, she accepted the title of Dame of the Commander of the British Empire, which was conferred upon her by Queen Elizabeth II. Dame Lois holds the distinction of being named Bermuda's first national hero in 2008. This lady, wife, mother, grandmother, and civic-minded woman broke numerous barriers and forever impacted the Bermuda landscape.
I'm Melanie Eddy, and I'm a Bermudian artist based in the UK. My medium is jewelry, and I work in precious metals, and I create sculptural jewelry forms. Sometimes when you work in an abstract way as an artist, it's very difficult for people to realize the inspiration behind your work. But actually, like a lot of my work, both in terms of the process by which I design and construct the work, and also the inspirations in terms of color palettes are strongly influenced by Bermuda. So the architecture of Bermuda, the fact that Bermuda historically has a central position and was part of you know, the eye of the trade and you know, in a way, the Bermuda Triangle. So it's no coincidence that my pieces are faceted with triangular facets all over them, but also often my choices in terms of gemstones and the kinds of metals I pair them with are based on some of my kind of favorite memories from Bermuda. So whether it's the color of sunsets, whether it's the joy of eating loquats from a tree, or the jingle of bangles that my grandmother wears. The Department of Culture in Bermuda supported my first set of extended training outside of the UK by a grant that allowed me to do a 2-month program at the Royal College of Art in 2004. And most recently, the Department of Culture supported me with an exhibition showcasing my work at Sotheby's as part of Brilliant in Black, an exhibition showcasing Black jewelers working in high jewelry.
Coming up next, we are going to celebrate Sir Henry James Jack Tucker. And the first person that's going to actually do a tribute to them, obviously we're going to do the video first, but we have Dennajye Paynter. Dennajye is a 17-year-old self-taught pianist. In 4 months, he was able to learn Mozart Piano Sonata number 11, okay, and Ronda alla Turca, also known as Turkish March. This is one of Mozart's famous pieces, and he's glad to perform it on this occasion. And I have to tell you, I emceed an event a few weeks ago, and I watched this young man come to the piano and start to play. And everybody there was like, how long have you been playing? Where did you get your training from? And when he told us that he was self-taught, I was absolutely amazed. Our young people in Bermuda are absolutely amazing to be self-taught. And you'll see when he comes up just how wonderful he is. Also, we have Amy Zanders. Amy is a Bermudian artist living in Liverpool who recently graduated from Liverpool John Moores University with a Master of Fine Arts degree. Amy has been in countless art exhibitions, including this year's Bermuda Biennial. While living in Liverpool, she continues to exhibit art with the Avoid Art Collective. Amy had the privilege of working with the TAT, Liverpool's Home From Home Art Program, where she taught art to the asylum seekers and refugees. Amy thoroughly enjoys running workshops and teaching art to people of all ages and abilities. Let's make some noise as we pay tribute to Sir Henry James Jack Tucker.
Sir Henry James Jack Tucker. Sir Henry James Jack Tucker is considered the architect of modern Bermuda. His political and professional life was a major part of Bermuda becoming the success story that it is today. He is a founding father of international business in Bermuda. In 1934, he began working at the Bank of Bermuda, where he eventually rose to become general manager in 1938, until his retirement in 1969. His political life saw him become a parliamentarian twice, in 1938 until 1948, and again in 1953 until 1971. In 1944, he successfully piloted the bill that gave Bermudian women who owned land the right to vote, after a first failed attempt the previous year. In 1964, he founded the United Bermuda Party, after the Progressive Labour Party had formed a year earlier. He was Bermuda's first government leader before retiring from politics in 1971.
Thank you. Zanders. I'm a Bermudian artist currently living in Liverpool. I work primarily now in video. My video art is mostly experimental. It's not like a traditional video, so I'm using layers mostly, using After Effects, learning how to do animation, but mostly paper cutout animation, and also rotoscoping and combining everything. So playing with those layers to create a feeling, an emotion, bringing together themes, but just piled up on top of each other. So you can't escape from where you were born or where you lived. It seeps into my work. So as much as I can't try to, instead of trying to work around it, I just use it and becomes part of my artistic vocabulary. So I use bright colors because, you know, we're surrounded by bright colors in Bermuda. The ocean is super blue. You can't see anything like that. We have like the gumbays. We have people wearing bright clothing. It's just the buildings, you know, they're bright colors. You can't escape it. So it's embedded. It's something I try, instead of trying to escape from it, I just embrace it and use it in there. So instead of me hiding who I am, I'm making people say, no, this is where I'm from and this is what it means. We're island people and we should be proud of ourselves and also what represents or has symbolic meaning to ourselves. So we should use it in our work. The Department of Culture have always been very supportive. This whole journey is because of them. When I was doing the art walk, they were the first sponsors. When I needed help with getting to school, they were very open to sponsoring me to get a grant to be out here. So without their support, I wouldn't be able to continue my work, continue exploring, or even advance or have this ability to be out here and just constantly learning and making. So thank you so much.
We have so much talent in Bermuda, and sometimes I think we fail to celebrate it. We're so quick to celebrate those that are from overseas, but let me tell you something, we have some really golden nuggets right here in the island of Bermuda. So can we make another round of applause for them? Did you see the young man that was self-taught? Yes. So the next national hero that we are going to celebrate is none other than the Honorable Sir John W. Swan, KBE, JP. And he's our only living national hero in Bermuda. So I'm going to ask if he can stand. Can we give him a loud round of applause, please? And what I will tell you about Sir John is that he is not afraid to give back. And over the years, I have gone to his office and he has actually provided advice to me as a mentor. So Sir John, I also honor you today personally, and that's why I had to walk away from the podium. You are deserving of this honor. There will also be a video tribute, but we also have Jesse Seymour who is gonna perform for you. Although Bermuda Idol 2016 winner Jesse Seymour stems from a family of talented musicians, he never foresaw being a professional artist himself. It wasn't until Jesse was challenged by a coworker in 2008 to get on stage and open for reggae artist Wayne Marshall did he discover that the stage was his home. Versed in reggae, R&B, and hip hop, this triple threat style and stage presence is one to be reckoned with. Having opened for artists such as Chris Brown, Joe, Taurus Riley, and Luciano, Jesse has made a name for himself in Bermuda. Jesse's goal is to represent Bermuda on a world stage, which I think he can, touching the hearts of all races and cultures through his music, paving the way for young Bermudian artists to follow. Give a round of applause for our national hero, Sir John W. Swan.
The Honorable Sir John W. Swan. Sir John Swan, a real estate developer, a political luminary, a philanthropist, and the longest serving Premier of Bermuda, is known not only for his astute political and entrepreneurial mind, but also for his warmth, humility, and gentlemanly demeanor. His parliamentary career started in 1972 and spanned 25 years. He held many posts during this period, such as Minister of Marine and Air Services and Minister of Immigration and Labor, where he initiated policies and practices that enhanced Bermuda's economic and social development. Sir John became Premier in 1982 and served in this post for 13 and a half years until his retirement from Parliament in 1997. The most significant legacy of his political career was in 1985, when he led the negotiations and the completion of the USA-Bermuda Tax Convention. This agreement resulted in the development of the insurance and reinsurance industries and established the island as a major offshore financial center, thus creating a foundation for the island's stable economy, well-developed infrastructure, and regulatory framework. Sir John was also a founding father of international business in Bermuda. Sir John has been recognized by numerous organizations for service to his country and community. One of the most significant was his appointment by Her Majesty the Queen in 1990 as a Knight Commander of the Order of the British Empire.
Told me never give up. Life's a long, long road, so I'ma run this relay for you and carry your torch. Friends and family are all here, yeah, to celebrate with you. Yeah, hoping this song eases the pain that you've been going through. Yeah, cause you're so amazing and your love's contagious. And every time I look into your eyes, like the stars are gazing. And I just want you to know that I'm proud of you every day and every way. Cause you're so amazing to me, and your love shining right through me, yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah. Life's trials and tribulations can get the best of us sometimes. But I'll take the load off you now. Carry yours and mine. I look up to the Father and I beg him time after time, just hoping he hears my voice and it gets you to the finish line. Cause you're so amazing and your love's contagious. And every time I look into your eyes, like the stars are gazing. I just want you to know that I'm proud of you every day and every way. Cause you're so amazing to me, and your love shining right through me, yeah, yeah. Oh no, the world knows you now. So go on and take a bow. Sing this one out loud. The world knows you now, so I'm gonna take a bow right now. Right now. contagious. And every time I look into your eyes, like the stars are gazing. And I just want you to know that I'm proud of you every day and every way. Cause you're so amazing to me. And your love shining right through me. Yeah, so amazing. So contagious. And every time I look into your eyes, like the stars are gazing. And I just want you to know that I'm proud of you every day and every way. Cause you're so amazing to me. And your love shining right through me. Yeah. Thank you.
Coming up next, we have a tribute to Mary Prince. We have Gherdai Hassell, who is a Bermudian-born, China-trained, multidisciplinary, contemporary artist and storyteller based in Manchester, UK. Her work investigates memory and nostalgia, to construct and deconstruct identity. Her collage work typically centers female bodies simultaneously existing within realms of past, present, and future. Diasporic pasts become reinformed by Black futures, where the resulting present is experienced as a living artifact or as her ongoing alibi configuration, which are both acts towards Afrofuturism. Her work is ultimately about migration, a gradual process of being and becoming the future. We also have Tiaje Williams. Tiaje Williams is an 18-year-old, thank you so much, that's okay, an 18-year-old dancer who recently graduated from the Greer School in Pennsylvania this past May. She's excited to attend George Mason University this fall with a concentration in dance and minor in psychology. Tiaje has trained at both the In Motion School of Dance and the Greer School in Ballet, Contemporary, Modern Jazz, and Gymnastic Techniques. When asked why she loved dancing, she says, "I adore dancing because of the infinite feeling of breath and air that flows through my bones." I love that. "I love to dance because at one point, it's all I had. It never fails to make me feel alive and secure. Dance ignites my vulnerability. It helps me to discover who I am and the person I aspire to be." Ladies and gentlemen, let's give a round of applause as we celebrate Mary Prince.
Mary Prince. Mary Prince was a Bermudian woman born as a slave at Brackish Pond, now known as Devonshire Marsh in Bermuda. Over her lifetime, she was owned by at least four different masters. She ended up in England, where she eventually ran away and sought help from the Anti-Slavery Society. In 1831, her autobiography, The History of Mary Prince, was published and had a galvanizing effect on the anti-slavery movement. This was the first account of the life of a Black woman to be published in the United Kingdom, and a first-hand description of the brutalities, cruelty, and inhumane treatment endured by slaves. The History of Mary Prince was released at a time when slavery was still legal in the British Caribbean colonies. It sold out three times during its first year of publication. Mary Prince is regarded internationally as an unsung heroine of the abolition movement.
My name is Gherdai Hassell, and I'm a Bermudian contemporary artist based in Manchester, UK. So my artwork is an exploration of identity through exploration of materials. My practice is heavily based in materiality. I am also doing some installation work, painting, and mostly collage work, and using layers of metaphor to explore what it means to inhabit this body and move through physical space, but not just physical space, but also digital space as well. And the work is always an investigation of this present moment
looking towards to the future as well. My artifact series is very different than my alibi series. So the artifact series manifests its way into the world by way of investigating the archive. And so I'm using archival imagery, the I Am Because You Are exhibition. I was looking at the archives in Bermuda, and I'm using that as a point of departure to investigate like past, present, future, and narratives related to Bermuda's history and slave trade and Bermuda's relationship with that. But my alibi series is very different from that. That work sort of emerged out of my experience in China, looking at myself as a Black woman based completely, totally out of context, and finding a way to sort of figure out what kind of work I wanted to make and also what was important for me. The Department of Culture helped to fund my initial I Am Because You Are solo exhibition at Bermuda National Gallery, and I'm so grateful for that opportunity. And then further, I also received a further education award to support my Masters of Contemporary Art at the China Academy of Art, which I've just completed and excited to have finally done that. So I'm very grateful for the department's support of my practice and you know, of my career.
Thank you.
Coming up next, we are going to celebrate our national hero, Dr. Edgar Fitzgerald Gordon, Dr. E.F. Gordon. And there's going to be an excerpt from the film Victory, which was produced by none other than Ulrich Richardson. He's a Bermudian veteran of media. Shortly after graduating from Rutgers University's Communications and Broadcasting Program, he was the anchor and news writer for the largest radio news team in the state, WCTC. He served as an announcer, sports director, news director, assistant general manager, and ultimately CEO of the Bermuda Broadcasting Company. After retiring 5 years ago, Rick began working on the production of Victory, the events surrounding the 1981 island-wide strike, regarded as the strike of all strikes. Let's give a round of applause as we celebrate Dr. E.F. Gordon.
Dr. Edgar Fitzgerald Gordon, also known as Mozumbo. Dr. Edgar Fitzgerald Gordon was both a physician and a parliamentarian, but his reputation and place in history stems in great part from his work as a labor leader. He is regarded as the father of the labor movement in Bermuda. Appalled by the segregation, social ostracism, and professional harassment experienced by Black people in Bermuda, Dr. Gordon wrote letters to newspapers championing the cause of Bermudian workers and equal rights for all Bermudians. A tireless proponent of reform in a Bermuda that stubbornly resisted even incremental steps that might advance its social development, Dr. Gordon prided himself on being an agent of change. He fearlessly challenged racism at every turn. His fight on behalf of Bermudian workers led to the founding of the Bermuda Workers Association in 1944, later the Bermuda Industrial Union. Dr. Gordon and his supporters took the fight for social and political change directly to the UK government with a landmark petition. The UK government did little to address the problems it highlighted, but Dr. Gordon and his supporters continued their push for reforms to address the treatment, conditions, and discrimination of the poor and working people of the island. In 1946, Dr. Gordon successfully won his third attempt to gain a seat as a member of the Colonial Parliament in a St. George's by-election. As a member of the Colonial Parliament, Dr. Gordon was relentless in challenging social and political inequities. With only 7% of the Black population eligible to vote, he pressed for the abolition of the property vote. When white parliamentarians refused to address him as Dr. Gordon in Parliament, he changed his name to Mozumbo, forcing them to address him by his African name. Mozumbo, Dr. Edgar Fitzgerald Gordon, was a leading figure in 20th century Bermuda. His activism and leadership brought about many of the reforms adopted after his death in April 1955.
Of Colonel Oliver Stanley in Bermuda, had attained a membership of 1,145. Male and female, white and colored workers throughout Bermuda. And we ask But in 2 years, despite the fact that there was no trade union bill on the statute books, and that many people were of the impression that our organization was illegal, and therefore they were afraid, despite that deterrent fact, we have reached a membership of nearly 5,000. Thus having established the largest organization in the history of Bermuda.
Now we're here to encourage you to walk into your new season, a season of freedom and a season of victory. Here it is. By the hand of the Almighty, I've been set free, healed, delivered, made complete. Now I'm walking in victory. Adrian, won't you help me sing it? By the hand of the Almighty, I've been set free.
This is Victory, the story of the unprecedented island-wide strike in Bermuda in 1981. Signaling the rise of the Bermuda Industrial Union under the leadership of Mr. Atul Simmons, and the greatest display of solidarity the island had ever seen. Victory outlines the origins of the labor movement in Bermuda and chronicles the foundation laid by the father of the labor movement, Dr. E.F. Gordon, a movement that in later years presented a significant challenge to the political house built by businessmen and political strategist Sir Henry Tucker.
Victory, you're my joy band. Oh, I'm walking in victory. Said I'm walking in
victory. The talks broke down.
Everything shut down.
Come out, we want to see you now. It's time.
Asked one of the Go Slow drivers to move on.
I want you to learn to show solidarity.
That the government is wrong.
There can be little doubt that the general strike had an equally dramatic effect on the economy.
It's only the people of Bermuda who have lost, and certainly as far as I'm concerned, no one has won.
We're going to move right along with the program, and our next national heroes is Gladys Misick Morrell. We have Brixx, who is a local musician, recording artist, and songwriter. Beginning as a shy teen doing talent shows, she has now risen into star power and is open for acts such as Monica and Coffee. Her songs enjoy play on local radio. She recently won second place in a Digicel international competition and has a song with over 5 million views on YouTube. As a YouTuber and an influencer, she has also begun all-female cyphers to empower other women artists. Can we give her a round of applause for that? Also, we have Tiffany Paynter. As one of Bermuda's leading spoken word artists, Tiffany Paynter has been honored to perform at the Heather Nova concert, the John Lennon concert, the Bermuda Festival, Earth Hour, International Women's Day Bermuda, and Bermuda Pride 2019, and TEDx Bermuda. Over the past 15 years, she has led poetry and spoken word classes or workshops at the Barclay Institute, Cedar Bridge Academy, the Chustick Foundation Retreats, Bermuda College, and Whitney Institute. In addition to her work, it has been selected by two international juries for the Bermuda National Gallery's biennial in 2014, 2018, and 2022. Can we give that a round of applause as well? At this time, we are going to celebrate national hero Gladys Misick Morrell.
Gladys Misick Morrell. In 1923, Gladys Misick Morrell was the founder of the Bermuda Women's Suffrage Society and spearheaded the first organized challenge to Bermuda's voting system in 300 years. The movement was a 25-year battle which culminated in women who owned property being given the right to vote in 1944. She also fought for better health care and college scholarships for women and co-founded the Bermuda Welfare Society, which established the district nursing system. Her activism not only paved the way for the election of Bermuda's first two female members of parliament in 1948, but was the forerunner of the battle for universal adult suffrage, which was achieved 20 years later.
Girl, and she's on fire, hotter than a fantasy, lonely like a highway. She's just a girl and she's on fire, filled with catastrophe, but you know she can fly away. Oh, she's got her feet on the ground and she's burning it down. Oh, she's got her head in the clouds and she's not backing down. This girl is on fire. Everybody watch as she goes by, cause they can see the flame that's in her eyes, watching as she's lighting up the night. Everybody knows that she's a lonely girl, and it's a lonely world, and she gon' let it burn, baby, burn, baby. Fire.
This poem is dedicated to my daddy. Daddy, you never remember my memories. You used to guard my dreams. I swore you spent days axe battling the boogeyman in my closet and the monsters under my bed. I swore you spent nights sleepwalking the hallway between our rooms, and you were water for the dragons. The fire for the ghouls. Your history taught me how to see the system. Before I could even spell resist, you had me prepped for the resistance. I remember stories of black berets, leather fists, and jackets, and how you lit buildings owned by bigots. Daddy, you were my Ferdinand, with flowers and hoof, but now you are all horns. See, I never wrote you in as one of them. Not when it was you spelling out the tyranny of isms, but I didn't see Jesus coming. My eyes couldn't bend around the corner of your baptism. But before I am a lesbian waiting for two words and a comma, I am just a daughter searching for a rescue poem for her father. If only words were a bridge of stones across the ones you've thrown. I'd replace my armor for pajamas and you'd already be carrying me back to bed. Have you forgotten how your souls were once the winds lifting my airplane body? How your arms embraced me like a runway? How you built me strong. Strong enough to survive, stepped on. But lately I've been boxing your souls and icing my fists. Lately my head feels knuckled and my heart puddles when you step. The nights you left me homeless, I felt like the top hat after the magic act, emptied of extraordinary. You never remember my memories. I had always left the Barbies butched up and buzz cut, a G.I. Jane figurine for each Jasmine. My Easy Bake saw more mud pies than cupcakes. I was ready for the revolution at 10, but by 18, I knew liberty, statued, and feminine, holding the torch of me between her thighs. I thought that the idea of grandchildren would crumble your Berlin walls, but the bricks of your shame were iron. You said any child of mine, adopted or otherwise, would be a heathen delivered into hell, and the well of me was emptied of all water and all wishes. So teach me how to love you now, because the truth is I still need to curl up on your belly, my breathing half moon on a sky of blankets. At 11, I'd listen to your heartbeat through your blowhole, half expecting you to spray the sea out. And I swore there were oceans inside you, oceans piled like sapphires, high and deep, oceans of anemones for the clown of me. Daddy, I never told you that your love was my alphabet, and that now I carry a language inside of me in webs of I ams, and I am a thousand Charlottes for your pot belly, because you are terrific, radiant, and humbling. You are a blue ribbon existence. So I'm quilting a silk banner in your doorway, trying to make poetry save our us from the slaughter of religion. Thank you.
And our next national hero is Sir Edward Richards, KTCBE. Celebrating him will be Sabriyya Harvey. She's a visual artist whose work involves piecing together her personal story through deconstructing generational memory and material culture. Those remembered things with long legacies of practice. Her work focuses on the theme of historical origin, the formation of traditions, and more importantly, storytelling. She explores the process of upholding culture through these memories in order to connect with her African Bermudian heritage, immortalizing narratives and drawing connections between our past and present through painting and sculpture. Her work has been selected by two international juries for the Bermuda National Gallery's biennial in 2022. We also have Rated E Dance Group. Rated E Dance Crew was founded by Sacha, Dill, and Kevante Jennings Lathan in August 2013. Their purpose is to touch, move, and inspire whilst expressing positive energy through the art of dance. During their time together, they have evolved not just as a group, but as a family. Each dancer plays a massive role in the effectiveness of this group's execution. Their logo was created to symbolize their journey and progression over the years. Their motto, which corresponds with their logo, is hard work, dedication, accomplish greatness. This group was created to exhibit a diverse and unique style of movement, as well as bringing individuals together in a positive manner. Let us now celebrate Sir Edward Richards, KTCBE.
Sir Edward Richards. Sir Edward Richards was one of a small group of visionaries who laid the foundations of present-day Bermuda. Sir Edward was involved in every major political shift and carved out a unique and unifying place in the emergence of modern Bermuda. In Parliament, Sir Edward focused on discrimination in the island's hotels and restaurants. From 1957 to 1961, he challenged this policy, meeting resistance in committee and in the House. In 1959, the 9-day boycott of the island's cinemas dealt the first blow to institutionalized racism. In 1961, the bill to desegregate restaurants that Sir Edward championed was passed, the first Bermuda statute of its kind. Sir Edward, along with others, targeted two great obstacles to equality, the unequal franchise and the segregated school system. In 1968, Bermuda received its constitution, underpinned by universal adult suffrage, and modern Bermuda came into being. Segregation of publicly funded schools was the last bastion of the old regime to fall in 1971. Sir Edward became Bermuda's first Black government leader in 1971, and then the first Premier of Bermuda the following year.
My name is Sabriyya Harvey. I am an artist based in Canada whose work focuses around spectatorship, ritual, and diverse examples of community in Bermuda. My art primarily manifests through painting, sometimes sculpture and drawing, but it really focuses on sort of connecting myself to my past and my history. So right now I'm focusing on looking at spectatorship as a ritual within Bermudian culture, but as I've also looked at abstracting sort of material cultures like the Gumbays and sort of translating that more into a visual culture to be shared with my audience. I'm kind of in a unique position where I'm making work about the island outside of the island. So throughout my undergrad, it really did focus on really, I guess, yeah, that Bermudian iconography. So those sort of figureheads that we think represent Bermudian culture, but sort of turning them in a way that changes them a little bit. So I guess viewing them from a more personal viewpoint as opposed to one that is more touristic that we usually see when we're looking at Bermuda. So I really sort of try to embody that sort of other or that perspective and take it on from my own experiences, my own relationships with myself and my Bermudians. Other than the fact that my work is really supported by those cultural traditions that the Department of Culture supports, in 2020, when I was awarded the Arts Council grant, during that time with the pandemic and everything, I really needed that financial support in my final year of my Bachelor of Fine Arts. So going into my final year, knowing that I was really supported financially and also in some ways, like artistically through what I was producing, it allowed me to sort of freely create in a way where I felt that my work had a place and it was, I guess, wanted.
Uno, two, three, four.
Coupe, bring it from Holland to Ghana, UK, London to Naja, Angola, Caverdiana. Coupe, Quara, bring it from Congo to Zambia, Senegal up to Italia, nationwide even España.
Shutting it down with a glass.
You'll know that we haven't been able to gather like this for the last 2 years, particularly for the premier's concert. So it's really a pleasure tonight to engage with all of you for our annual premier's concert. This year is particularly special, as the premier's concert has served as an occasion for us to celebrate our national heroes. So I want to start by thanking all of our talented artists, our singers, our poets, our visual artists, our dancers, for your amazing performances. This year's concert, of course, featured several artists who have received sponsorship from either the Department of Culture or the Bermuda Arts Council this past year. And we're absolutely pleased to demonstrate our commitment to supporting our Bermudian creatives in a way that is meaningful and purposeful. By way of background, the Premier's Concert, I've been made to understand, was first introduced in December of 1985 as a way of providing a platform to showcase Bermuda's performing artists and visual artists. So for the past 3 decades, this event has evolved, and each year we continue to be treated with an incredible display of excellence. So tonight, it's been a very gratifying occasion to celebrate artistic expression, and I certainly want to thank all of the volunteers, all of the persons behind the scenes organizing, particularly our hardworking team at the Department of Culture, who continue to go above and beyond to make sure that our artists are seen as well as heard. So thank you, once again for joining us, and we look forward to seeing you next year. Thank you. God bless you.
At this time, we're going to have a tribute to Dr. Paulo R-N-O-B. Can we get it right? Camaraca Fego. Yes. Did I get it right? Just making sure. Original Live Wires is a songwriter, producer, singer, tap dancer, and actor. As a Gumbe warrior dancer, during his primary school years, Live Wires received his first taste of public performance while a member of the instrumental band Sophisticated Gents, playing the E-flat saxophone. Does anybody remember Sophisticated Gents? One person over on the side. As a youth, Livewire spent his summers traveling to the United States as a member of the Detroit Cultural Renaissance Center's show choir. In recent years, Livewire has performed at the Bermuda Music Festival. He has performed in Barbados, the Bahamas, Canada, New York, Detroit, and Boston. He has opened for Toni Braxton, Collie Buds, UB40, Shabaranks, Shaggy, Maxi Priest, and Taurus Riley. Celebrating Dr. Paulo, I would like to bring to the stage right now, well, actually, we have a tribute first, and then we will bring to the stage original Live Wires.
Dr. Paulo Camaraca Fego, formerly known as Roosevelt Brown, was a civil rights leader, a political activist, a parliamentarian, and an ecological engineer who used his voice and his mind to initiate change in Bermuda and around the world. He worked tirelessly and courageously to significantly empower people around the world. In 1960, he formed the Committee for Universal Adult Suffrage, which was directly responsible not only for galvanizing support for adult suffrage, but for realizing voting rights for all adults through the eventual passing of the Parliamentary Election Act of 1963. The work of Dr. Paulo and the Committee for Universal Adult Suffrage also influenced the formation of the first political party in Bermuda, the Progressive Labour Party. His list of achievements, accomplishments, and awards are legion. An academic of international acclaim and regard, he taught all over the world, maintaining consultancies to governments and a number of international organizations, including the Commonwealth Secretariat and the United Nations Development Program. Dr. Paulo Camaraca Fego's philosophy in life was that one should always give back to society wherever they are.
Yeah, turn it up, please. Bermuda, number one. Number one. Hands in the air, please. Come on. Gumbe, 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 yeah. If you don't Gumbe warrior, let me see your hands in the air, Bermuda. If you don't Gumbe warrior, let me see your hands in the air, Bermuda. If you don't Gumbe warrior, let me see your hands in the air, Bermuda. If you don't Gumbe warrior, let me see your hands in the air, Bermuda. The Gumbe warrior, hurry. And bring up mine, and break down the barrier. Beat the Gumbe drum, and set the demagarians. And my team, Bermuda. If you don't Gumbe warrior, let me see your hands in the air. Go! If you don't Gumbe warrior, let me see your hands in the air. Come on, come on, come on. If you don't Gumbe warrior, everybody. Let me see your hands in the air. Everybody. If you don't Gumbe warrior. And now you air it on your radio. Let's turn it up on your radio. Now every massive band, sing hey. Let me see your hands in the air.
No, no.
If you don't obey.
No, no.
Let me see your hands in the air. If you don't obey, warrior, let me see ya.
Hold up.
If you don't obey, let me see ya. If you don't obey,
again. Come on, hold up.
If you don't obey, let me see ya. Yeah.
If you don't go back, warrior. Yeah.